At Titleist, our focus is really on the serious golfer. And the serious golfer means someone who works on their game. They generally take lessons, they practice a lot, they play frequently. And we take what we learn on tour as far as performance. What's the best ball flight for a golfer? What are the different options? And then we translate that for those of us who don't swing as fast as touring professionals. So we've got obviously different shaft flexes, different options for them, but always focused on the needs of the serious golfer.
Mike, you've told me that you play a 52 degree, a 56 degree, and a 60 degree wedge.
Yeah.
So we're going to start with the 52 degrees in three different models, the SM2s, the TVDs, and the 200 series. I've set them all to standard loft, standard lie angle. I'm gonna watch you hit a few shots with each, see if we need to make any adjustments, get your feedback and my eye, and decide which way we're gonna go with the 52 degree wedge.
And Volke basically has come up with this different layout based on his experience with tour players and average players.
If you go to the PGA Tour right now, you'll see all three of these wedges in play plus others. So everything that we do is based off how Bob has designed his wedges and how Bob fits wedges. So let's hit a few with that. So as I'm watching you through the turf on a couple, you're fairly shallow right down here as we go through. No real deep divots yet. Lie angle looks acceptable. Let's try the TVD right here and see what we see as you hit that one. Now, do you see a different flight on that shot than you did with the previous wedge?
I did. I think it was more self-created than the wedge itself. Yeah, that's a little fatter.
All right, one more with that, and tell me if you preferred the first one or the second one.
I think I felt crisper on the first one.
You know, and as we're looking at these wedges, we can see that the second wedge has a different grind on the sole, and it's got a different bounce than the first one. So it looks like, right now, your swing performs a little bit better with a little narrower sole without the grind. So as we go into the 200 series, let me find something similar and see what you think about that. Really good. Okay, now I'm gonna make one slight adjustment to this. So hit the first one again a couple of times to get a feel for that while I make an adjustment. I'll be right back.
Well, fitting is really a big part of what we do to help golfers get better. So we know that you want to have the best equipment possible in order to get your best chance to perform. So we think the best way to do that is to get fit for every club that you buy, because finding the right makeup in your bag, the right specs for your club, really does lead to better performance. And really, that's what the serious golfer's after, is how can I perform better? How can I get equipment that helps me be more consistent, or hit better shots, or reduce my miss hits.
All right, now, one thing that you should notice. When you hit the original wedge I gave you, the 250-212, and you hit the knockdown shots, it was really good through the turf. It didn't dig. When we go to the 5208, the standard shots were great, but when you tried to hit the knockdowns, you took a little more turf. But what I'm seeing is that when you hit the knockdown wedges, your divots are much shallower, much flatter across the bottom. When you hit the lower bounce wedge, the 8 for the knockdown shot, you take a little bit deeper divot, and sometimes the club will catch in the turf rather than gliding through. So I think if you're going to play some knockdown shots in a round, I would prefer to see you in a little higher bounce wedge than a lower bounce wedge. You had a lot of success hitting this up in the air for a stock shot. Hit a couple more knockdowns with it.
Yeah, kind of.
It runs up the face a little bit. You can't keep it as flat.
Yeah.
And that's the difference in the bounce on the sole. So I think what we're seeing is that between the two wedges, the 5212 and the 5208, we see shallower divots with the 5212 than with the 5208. The 5208 works great if we're looking for the higher trajectory full shot. The 5212 shows a little bit of an advantage when you're trying to hit the lower flighted knockdown shot, if you will, and it still is perfectly acceptable on the full shot. As we look at different techniques, you'll find that the sweeper player, the one who doesn't take a lot of divots, generally prefers a lower bounce wedge. where the players that come in a little bit more steep or maybe prefer a lower trajectory prefer more bounce. And while it is subtle on the sole of some of these models, when you look at the grind wedges, like the M wedges, you can see a more pronounced bounce and grind on the sole. We would say that if you're more of a digger, you'd like the higher loft if you come in and take deep divots. Right. And if you're a little more shallow, you'd prefer the 52. So after we have completed the 52 and we've made our choice here, we'll move on to the 56 and then the 60. And then 60, not only do we do full swings, but we are going to work around the green and get in the sand, because that's extremely important with the lob wedge.